What does it really mean to invest in the Black community?
It means empowering the Black financial institution behind that dollar. This is Banking on Us.
Let's talk about the challenges of starting a Black business.
My name is Rhonda. I am an insurance agent. I consult with individuals about their benefits. When the pandemic initially hit and we kept seeing and hearing that there was relief coming to small businesses like myself, I was banking with another institution. As the pandemic wore on, my frustration grew. I couldn't contact anyone either by phone. There was no response to my emails. It's a misconception out there that we are not professional or knowledgeable or even capable. Of course, that's not true. Given the opportunity, we can outperform our competitors or others that are in the same field.
I'm Chanel, and I'm a doula and the founder of Naturally Nurtured Birth Services. A doula provides emotional, educational, and physical support to a birthing person. So a lot of times we see those commercials that come on, you've been pre-approved for this, or you know, we value you as a customer. Our customers mean this to us and that to us. And you see these things and you think, okay, well, this could apply to me, but when you go, it's kind of like every door is kind of closed in your face. You have to already have a certain amount in the bank with them in order to move forward in a different process. But on the other hand, it's like, well, how do you get to that point if you don't even get a chance to start?
My name is Colby, and I am the lead floral designer for Premier Flowers. Some of the biggest challenges that Black businesses face is access to capital.
Access to capital and funding is, you know, really important.
There are more payday lenders than McDonald's in Mississippi. And again, you don't see banks and traditional credit unions in the communities that need it most.
Cash advance is not the bank. You know, payday loan, that's not a bank.
I was banking with another institution that really didn't offer anything back, even though I had been banking with them for quite a long time, just jumping through a lot of hoops. Expecting a lot for someone just starting out, you know, making it difficult to access those funds.
The fact that many of these businesses benefit from a banking relationship, typically bankers will help you understand how to build a balance sheet, how to leverage different sources of capital, etc. And these relationships have been absent from many businesses in Black communities.
If you listen to LLC Twitter, you may think that those coins you're putting towards that one takeout meal of the week you deserve should be put towards your newest LLC. We can sit here and discuss the hypotheticals all day, but in this episode, we're going to discuss the facts.
In 2012, it seemed like new businesses were being launched by the hour, which is essentially a beautiful thing.
There are more than 2 million Black-owned businesses in the United States, and that number is growing daily. But then the pandemic hit, and by April 2020, our nation lost close to 450,000 Black businesses, a devastating 41% drop, while white businesses only experienced a 17% decrease from the same pandemic. So you're saying in the middle of a pandemic that seemingly leveled everyone and put us all in the same boat, Black people were still catching the short end of the stick? Yes, and unfortunately, it doesn't start or end there. Where it really begins is with the laws and policies in place and the lack of education around certain business methods and practices that other communities are leaning into. Methods like investing in entities to split the profit or returns, crowd and equity funding, and so many more that we as a community are just not leaning into for a number of reasons. Black business owners receive less business financing, less often, and at way higher rates than other races. Only 1% of Black business owners obtain business loans in the first year. So what is really going on with the gap between Black-owned businesses and the others? And what are the things we need to know to bridge the gap or just close it altogether?
Hope shifted to the PPP, to the Paycheck Protection Program, to get loans out. And we were able to help over 5,000 businesses.
I found out about Hope Credit Union from one of the bank employees at another lending institution.
The process with Hope was a lot simpler. Getting that access to capital, not having to use my own funds, having an institution that will lend funds in order to for me to reach the goals I'm trying to get to.
Well, the experience getting connected to Hope Credit Union was phenomenal during a very dark time because, you know, at one point we were closed due to COVID, due to the pandemic, and Hope helped us to stay in business.
Now, business ownership is not easy. You've got to have that support. And so what Netflix Deposit has done, it has been a game changer in our ability to close the wealth gap.
Black woman entrepreneurship, it means freedom.
And so I'm really proud that I'm able to continue with my family legacy, not only because I'm Black, but because I'm a woman as well.
You want to invest and put your money into a bank that pours back into you.
We have to invest in Black businesses in order for us to continue to thrive and strive and be afforded some of the things that are promised to the American dreamer. We want our apple pie. I want my house with the picket fence and two cars, the whole bit.
These relationships have been absent from many businesses in Black communities. Enter Black banks. Many of them do this as a first principle. And that's why they're better leveraged at helping to empower these communities than many of the better capitalized major banks.